What has happened to our understanding of the goddess, the divine feminine, in contemporary times? Why is women's sexuality so exploited, so debased, when once it was revered? How can men come to know and to value the deeper meaning of femininity? And why is sexuality cut off from spirituality as if it were opposites? My mind goes back to a time when the ancient temple was a place where the priestess, a sacred prostitute, served the goddess, and where men would come to honor her through sacred acts of love and worship. Who was the sacred prostitute, and what happened to the developing consciousness of humankind when people no longer venerated the goddess of love, passion, and sex? Ancient rituals, gestures, and movements still live in my body like some unconscious cellular memory. The archetypal figure of sacred, passionate love still lives within us as women. She has gone underground. In the background, she still lives within us, moving us towards a more complete and healed split of our own psyche. Without the vital feminine to balance the collective patriarchal principle, there is a certain barrenness to life. Creativity and personal development are often stifled. There is no balance, no harmony, neither within oneself nor in the external world. She is the consecrated priestess in the temple, spiritually receptive to the feminine power flowing through her from the goddess, and at the same time joyously aware of the beauty and passion in her human body. Surrendered to the cosmic energies of love, she magnifies the goddess in physical delight and spiritual ecstasy. She opens the masculine to the potency of penetrating to the divine, and the feminine to the rapture of surrendering to it. The mystery of that union dwells beyond the finite bounds of personal love. Imagine, if you will, traveling to a foreign land, a strange land where only a few have journeyed. There we come upon the ruins of an ancient civilization now forgotten. Imagine the life once lived here. Our mind's eye can see the temple as it once must have been, glistening in the sunlight. We peer into the inner sanctuary. There, a figure moves gracefully before the altar, illuminating the lights by bringing fire within. Behold, the priestess of the temple, the goddess of love. Concealed by veils, we see her only dimly, yet in the flickering light, we discern her shapely feminine outline. Her perfume, with its musk-like aroma, creates an aura which stimulates and enriches physical desire. As she moves through the temple, she begins to dance to the music of the flute, tambourine, and cymbals. Her gestures, her facial expression, and the movements of her supple body all speak to the welcoming of passion. There is no false modesty regarding her body, and as she dances, the contours of her feminine form are revealed under an almost transparent robe. Her movements are graceful, and she is well aware of her beauty. She is full of love, and as she dances, her passion grows. In her ecstasy, she forgets all restraint and gives herself to the deity and to the stranger. So how do we heal this split between sexuality and spirituality? How do we take off the shells from our eyes to see the inherent purity and beauty of the feminine and within her the archetype of the sacred prostitute? For without her gifts of sensuality, emotions, and reminding us of the presence of each moment, something is lost with our daily life, leaving us cleaving and yearning for deeper meaning and creativity, often burying our deeper passion away till it becomes so hidden that we can no longer find it. Or we misuse this energy in the world, causing harm and destruction, or use the mask of the goddess as a guise for lust. Instead, let us use it for health and connection to everything, knowing that both matter and flesh are sacred.